podcast by Donut Media. And guys, we got to jump right in. It's a huge weekend for AJ and a huge show for us.
Huge weekend. I don't know. I don't know what you might be talking about, man.
I don't know, man. Just maybe some race. Might be the biggest event of the year.
Yeah, the race. Yeah. All jokes aside, man, we've been preparing for this one for a long time, and I feel good. I feel real, real good.
You're always so chill, so calm. It's hard to tell, man. Are you feeling the pressure?
Yeah.
The whole world's watching. I don't freak you out.
Look, man, it's a big race, and I'm not gonna lie. It's a huge one for me personally. There's a certain score to settle with a certain somebody.
Oh man, who could that be?
Ooh, it's a mystery.
I mean, this is a huge challenge for your relatively new to the scene driver.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's good. We're not calling him Rook anymore.
I think they've done enough. They've earned the new title.
They've done more than that. They've more than proven their worth many times over. Let me tell you, when I see them drive, it's like seeing a younger, better, faster version of me. Even better looking, better hair.
I wouldn't say that.
Thank you.
You're a handsome guy. I'm not going to lie. Thank you.
I would not want to be Bruno Duran right now.
I would.
No.
But it is good to hear that you got your confidence back. It's good to hear that you're feeling tip top going into the weekend.
Yeah. We get that fighting spirit vibe, you know? All of us, we feel good, but we also know we got a job to do, so.
That's good to hear, man. Well, we're glad that you're feeling good. We wish you guys the best of luck. We will be pulling for you here at Donut.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate you.
We'll see you on the other side, bro.
Hey, it's Bruno here. Just wanted to contact you to say I hope there's no hard feelings. You ran a hell of a race. Beat me fair and square. And guess what? I had fun. I actually enjoyed every second of that race. Well, up till the end, but still. You know what? Just enjoy the attention, because you really deserve it. Don't get too relaxed, though. Not going to want to be off that top spot for long. I'll see you around, superstar.
Wow. Awesome. I can't believe it. We're all proud of you. The team, man, the team, they're going wild. You're number one, and you are ready to defend it. This is the peak now, superstar. You hold on to it.
Now, if you're listening to this podcast, we know you saw the race this weekend, and what a race it was. We are in the studio with Bruno Durant himself. Bruno, how are you feeling?
Surprisingly okay. Surprisingly okay.
Not what I expected to hear. given your previous attitude on our show, can I just say?
Yeah, well, you know, it's just part of the show.
Well, we got to give respect where respect is due. It was a hard-fought loss. I don't think you could win
That's well
any
put.
Better than
I
that.
I like that, a hard-fought loss.
I got to ask, Bruno, did you have fun out there? Because it looked like you might have been having a little bit of fun.
I didn't know that getting beat could be so enjoyable. Anybody who's a fan of racing, which at my core I am, would appreciate what we did out there. That was a hell of a race.
It was.
Yeah,
fun to watch. A lot of crazy moves out there. A lot of unpredictable maneuvers.
And I think that might be the biggest bombshell we have ever dropped on our audience. Bruno Durant had fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, but
Headline.
You know, you got to give credit where credit's due. The team did great. We were ready, and there's no excuses. But you know, it's one thing to lose, but when you get beat, you know, that's something that any athlete, any champion can take well. You gotta just, I mean, they just ran a perfect race. And you know, and that's what it took. It was gonna take the perfect race.
Well, by the sound of things, you're not going anywhere. So, Bruno,
absolutely not.
What's coming up, man? What are your plans moving forward?
Stay the course. You know, it got us this far. We may enter this one with a bit more humility. I think I understand what AJ talked about after his first loss.
Learning to lose. I was going to bring that up.
Yeah. Yeah. You know,
do you think you've learned to lose a little bit?
A little bit, once. But yeah, I think it's something that, you know, the whole team can take back. It's just not your day, and it's somebody else's, and that's okay. This rookie just came out of nowhere, but they put in the hours, and I can't feel bad about that, because I think, you know, it shows that the sport's in a good place, and the future's secure. You know, there'll be someone else after this person, and then after that, and that's all we want. But as for now, I'm going to stay the course. We're going to go back. We're going to put in the hours. And I look forward to a rematch.
Well, it's very admirable.
Yeah, Bruno, I got some bad news for you. That microphone is live. So people all over the country and the world really might now know that you're a good guy.
Don't go that far.
The jig is up, man. Secret's
no,
out.
No. It's you
Bruno
know what, the
Durant
thing is
a human, ladies and gentlemen, and sounds like a pretty good one at that.
Very good one.
Selfless,
well,
I'd say.
Still nastiest one on the track, though.
No doubt about that.
Don't get, don't. I'm never gonna get too complacent out there.
I still got some wounds that may never heal.
I'm still afraid of you. So.
Yeah. What did you call me? The shark at one point.
Yeah, shark.
I'm the shark that never sleeps.
I think we called you a snake at one point,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, a lot of animals. A lot of animal references.
Okay, that one I might have missed.
Well, yeah, we didn't say that.
We didn't call you a snake.
No.
Don't do
never.
It. Well, Bruno, I never thought I would say this, but I've enjoyed having you in the studio today.
Imagine that.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
Wow. What an arc for all three of us, huh?
Look at us, guys.
We've all learned something today.
All right. Got to take care of some sponsorship stuff. You know why you're here. You know who I am. You probably don't care. We are talking total, complete victory with AJ. AJ, it is the Dirt Podcast by Donut Media. How you feeling, bro?
I'm feeling real good, man.
Dude,
I'm
feeling
real good. What a race. What a race.
Dude, I know. I was absolutely speechless.
No. You were not speechless, James. You were yelling a lot.
Yeah.
Saw a lot of sweat dripping down your forehead.
I can believe that.
Dude, I don't remember anything that happened that day. I totally blacked out. All I remember is AJ won.
So, like, what was the vibe right before the race?
You know, we all knew that going in would be pretty intense. We knew that Bruno had the crowd on his side, and honestly, all due respect to Duran, he turned up. He really turned up.
100% agree, dude. There was no luck involved here. It was two racers on absolute peak form, leaving everything out on the track. Just textbook competition.
Yeah, this is a very special victory for your team, AJ. You mentored this racer to victory. It was a big risk. You must be so proud, man.
Super proud. That's the perfect word. And look, we won our way. We never once forgot why we race in the first place, and I feel a little inspired, to be honest.
I mean, are you gonna finish that sentence? Because it sounds
all right. It's convinced me to shake off the cobwebs and get back out there.
Yeah!
Just see how it goes.
Oh my God, dude! You can't. If this is some sort of joke, you gotta stop
because I
cannot handle this. You're coming back.
Let's just get real.
Dude.
You couldn't keep me away if you tried.
Oh, man, I was so scared.
This time, though, there's no drama. There's no huge goals. There's win or lose. I miss the competition. And, you know, you got to enjoy the comeback.
Oh,
you
gotta dude.
You got to enjoy the comeback.
You keep dropping bombshells like this on this show, man. Retiring. I'm coming back.
I got to keep you on your toes, man. I don't want you to get comfortable.
Really helps our ratings, too. Thank you very much.
Oh, man. Okay. All right. Got to ask. Got to clarify. Do you have anything particular in mind?
Yeah, may seem only right that I would do a rematch if Duran is, you know, still down. Yeah, I see that look. Okay, yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
That is exactly what we wanted to hear.
I want Bruno. I want Bruno.
Yeah. All right, you guys, you heard it here first. Rematch number two.
Amazing.
Coming soon.
Yeah, well, before we get too far down that road, I'm going to need a warm-up. I'm not saying I'm cold, but I don't want to come in, you know, too fresh, and I think I've got the perfect person that make the perfect opponent. I just can't say anything on the record here, so.
Okay, so you're trying to be coy, yeah, but AJ, it is painfully obvious who that person is.
I have no idea what you mean. I have no idea.
Okay, so AJ, congratulations to your team. It has been such an honor for our team to be a part of this entire journey for you, and we can't wait to see what you guys got in store. But right now, you guessed it.
All right, you know what? I'm not gonna let you go to break without saying it. Here it is. I'll call it out on your show. Rookie, I'm talking to you. I'm proud of you. But you've been running around, and, you know, now you're winning all these races all over the place. Like, you're a real hot shot. But there's one more race you got to win. This Saturday, you're going down. Me and you. You gotta race me.
Dude, the teacher versus the student this Saturday. We'll be there. Don't be square. Now, can we go to the sponsors?
not bad. Not bad at all, don't you think? I'm talking about myself, of course, and that was me at like 80%. So I'm feeling pretty good about my chances next season. I think I'm really coming back. So you better watch out. Oh, and yeah, you know, you were pretty good too. But I guess I don't need to tell you that anymore.